Here some meanings are there. Let's discuss these meanings. First meaning in line with. In line with. Following or in accordance. Means what? You are in a line with the following tradition. Means what? You are following the particular tradition. You have to remember these meanings. Suppose they'll ask that what is the meaning of in a line with? Means what? In a line means what? In a following process. In a line means what? You know, line. Similar. The last thing is what? The least important thing. It can be used in a general English that the last but not least. Last thing means what? That thing having lowest priority, having lowest priorities, or we can say least importance. That's the last thing. It is the thing that we used to do in our daily life. Let's take an example that your mom gave you a list of buying things that you have to purchase in the market. Okay, and the last product is what is it is written in bracket that the last thing. Last means what? It is the lowest priority. If you will not get, it's alright. But you have to purchase the first because it is on the first. Got it? Similarly, in the rank system also. In the rank, first rank is best, most priority. People will ask, people will call, they will give you full admire, they will admire you and you will get a lots of privilege. But the last one, no one will ask you, who is last one, so on. That is the situation. Got it? Check it out, very simple word, find out, okay? Suppose I am explaining a chapter and suddenly I'll ask you that tell me what is the meaning of this word, and someone suddenly asks that sir on which page and in which para the word is, so I'll say this on the second page, fourth para, check it out. Means what? Find out this word, that is check it out. Got it? Very simple. Headed straight for means what? Went towards. Headed straight for, this is headed, munda, matha, means what? You are heading straight there, means you are moving forward, not backward. Got it? This is called headed straight for, means what? Went towards. Or we can say, suppose here is the book and you are moving from here, means you are straight forwarding towards the book. Top honors, honors means what? Awards. We can say honorable, mananiya. You know, mananiya prime minister, honorable prime minister Shri Narendra Modi, mananiya pradhan mantri Shri Narendra Modi. So this is called honorable, means mananiya is top honors, means what? Highest awards. Got it? As the prime minister, prime means also first, sorry, prime means best. Prime means what? Best. Seen in, be understood. Seen in, be understood. Sink, there is a two, there are two word, two meanings of the word. Sink is dubna. In Hindi we can say that suppose if you will throw a stone in the pond, it will directly sink in. It will not float. The sinking means what? Dubna. That's it. That is only sink. Here the word is sink in. Sink in, it means be understood. Be understood. Got it? Very important. Now, fervent. Fervent means what? Having a strong feeling. Having a strong feeling. I am having fervent that exam will postpone. No, not possible at all. So, I have a strong feeling that exam will postpone. Okay? I am having fervent that my dad is going to buy me a bike. This is not also possible. It is in your dream. You don't have a strong feeling. Got it? Now, Part 1, Santosh Yadav. Santosh Yadav, we are going to discuss the story of this personality. Okay? Yes. The only woman in the world who has scaled Mount Everest twice was born in the society where the birth of son was regarded as a blessing and a daughter, though not considered as a curse, was not generally welcome. See, the Santosh Yadav, she is a woman and she reached the height of Mount Everest. She reached the height of Mount Everest twice. She scaled, means she has scaled it. She has, in Hindi we can say, उन्हें माप लिए पूरा Mount Everest चढ़ के आ गए हैं two times. This is a lot, biggest achievement. Okay, अपने पावागढ़ चढ़ के जाएंगे तो अपने को half जाते हैं. तो this she just you know Mount Everest. She Mount Everest. Okay, so biggest achievement for her. But the statement is here that she is born in that society where the boys are considered as a, you know, what boys are, they are admired a lot, they a lots of love are given to them, and girls are considered as a, you know, ghar mein raho, don't go outside, don't talk to boys and don't talk to anyone, do your stuff, kachra karo, kachra saaf karo, aur kachra, here the boys used to say kachra karo and the girls kachra saaf karo, tum khana kha lo, tum bartan dho do, tum kapde si dho, kapde dho do, tum kapde pehen lo, fir kapde gande bhi kar do, tum aur kapde idhar dho bhi do. This is the procedure of Indian society. Okay, and I am that kind of guy that I used to do all the stuff by myself only. Okay, but you know what, Indian culture is that see के भाई अगर आप मतलब लड़कों को बचपन से ऐसा नहीं सिखाओगे तो वो बंदा भी उसी मोड में रहेगा. ओके, अगर पापा को कभी देखा है तो रोटी बनाते होंगे, रेयर कंडीशन में, चलो किसी घर में बनता भी होगा, मेरे घर में भी खुद के घर में बनता है, कभी मेरे पापा बनाते हैं, तो दैट इज अ रेयर कंडीशन, मींस इसका चांसेस ही 100 में से 1 या 5% बनता है. लेकिन बचपन से ही लड़कों को उस तरह से ट्रेनिंग नहीं दी जाती. अगर लड़कों की नजर से देखो कि भाई लड़का ये नहीं करेगा, ये लड़कों का काम नहीं है, दैट इज अलग पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. बट द पॉइंट इज हियर, दे आर नॉट एवर टॉट. अभी 5-10 साल का लड़का है, उसको तुम बोलो कि चलो कपड़े धोने बैठना है, द फर्स्ट थिंग एक्साइटेड इनसाइड, तो वो तो 0% है. गर्ल्स को भी नहीं आएगी पहले, लेकिन गर्ल्स को 10 साल में, गर्ल्स को जब से सिखाया जाता है फिर वो काम करने लगते हैं. लेकिन इधर वो ट्रेनिंग नहीं दी जाती, ट्रेनिंग से सब इंसान ट्रेन हो जाएंगे. ओके, उन्हें यही है भाई, जाओ खेलने जाओ, रविवार जाओ खेलने जाओ. ओके, सो दिस आर द सिचुएशन दैट इज कॉल्ड सो कॉल्ड ऑर्थोपेडिक ऑर्थोडॉक्स मेंटालिटी ऑफ ह्यूमन ऑफ इंडियन सोसाइटी. ओके, कि लड़के ही काम ही करे. ओके, चलिए आज की तारीख में गर्ल्स को फिर भी काफी फैसिलिटीज मिल रही है, सब शादी के बाद भी हस्बैंड वाइफ दोनों जॉब करते हैं और कॉलेज के टाइम से उनको ऐसी फैसिलिटी मिलती है कि वो जॉब करें. सी, वो जॉब करेंगे तो डिपेंडेंट बनेंगे, सेल्फ डिपेंडेंट. ओके, वो भी कुछ परचेस करना चाहेंगे, उनके भी कुछ रिक्वायरमेंट्स होंगे जो वो भी फुलफिल करना चाहेंगे. अब सब पेरेंट्स पे डिपेंडेंट रहेंगे तो कैसे चलेगा, एक पप्पा है 150 बच्चे हैं तो 150 बच्चों को कौन खिलाएगा. सो दिस इज द सेकंड पॉइंट, उसको जॉब के समझना, तो उन्हें भी अपनी कुछ डिमांड्स एंड फुलफिल पूरी करनी होती है. सो दैट इज द मेंटालिटी कि अब सोसाइटी में काफी बदलाव आ रहे हैं. अब गर्ल्स खुद भी बाहर जाते हैं तो गर्ल्स बाहर जाएंगे तो बॉयज को छत मारे काम करना पड़ेगा, अब वो कपड़े काम गंदा करेंगे ताकि छत मार उनको धोना पड़ेगा. सो दिस इज सिचुएशन, ये ऑटोमेटिक चेंज आ रहा है. चेंज नेवर कम्स एट इंस्टेंस. ओके, इट विल टेक अ टाइम. ओके, सो यू शुड टेक योर टाइम. बॉडी को भी चेंज होने में काफी समय लगता है. ओके, कभी देखा है कि दसवीं में बच्चा है और नेक्स्ट ईयर उनके पूछे आगे, ऐसा तो नहीं होता ना. तो बॉडी को टाइम होता है तो समय भी चेंज हो जाएगा. बट सी, यहाँ पे सिचुएशन ऐसा नहीं था. उस टाइम पे उनको काफी दिक्कतें होती थी. माउंट एवरेस्ट चढ़ने जाना है, अकेले बाजार तो भेजते नहीं है लड़कियों को, माउंट एवरेस्ट क्या चढ़ेंगे वो. तो दिस इज नॉट माई वर्ड, मेरा वर्ड नहीं है, ये पेरेंट्स का कहना होता है, पापा कहना होता है. अगर लड़की खुद देखे नहीं, आज मुझे रात में घूमने जाना है, मैं 8-9 बजे घर पे आ जाऊँगा, तो वो बेचारी क्या बोलेगी, फिर हो जाता है कि बाबा चलो, और दूसरे दिन से बाहर से खाना मंगवाना पड़ता है. दिस इज द सिचुएशन. तो उनको लगता है ये महंगा पड़ रहा है, अगर 8 बजे वो आ जाते तो आपको 100 में बच जाता, यहाँ पे 2000 में पड़ रहा है. नाउ When her mother was expecting Santosh and traveling holy men giving her his blessing, assume that she wanted a son. But to everyone's surprise, the unknown child's grandmother, who was standing close by, told him that they did not want a son. The holy man was also surprised. You see, okay, I'm surprised the unknown child's mother who was standing. Yes, Yamini. See, here the mom's, the Santosh mom, okay. There was a holy man, he came and he said that Tathastu aapka putra hi ho baba. But she told that no, I don't want a boy. It's as the bacha is not janmai, but she told that I don't want a boy, I want a girl. So this holy man Tathastu wala, he is also surprised, definitely. That why he gave the requested blessing and his destiny would have it, the blessings being to her. So he said, Tathastu, ladki baba. The blessing seemed to her. Santosh was born the sixth child in the family with five sons. See, they have already five sons. The whole Lalai family, they have already five sons. Then also they are asking for boy only. Now, but the she told that I am thaki gayi bana. So I want a girl now. Okay, I have to do lots of work by myself. I want a girl so I can take care of by myself. I can, you know, bless my pure love towards her. We have a lad, five lathai in our house. What are we going to do with this? Okay, they all are in number ka nalai. So this is the situation. So here the situation is changing because her mother took a stand for her. Her mother took a stand for her that I want a girl, so I can teach her, I can, you know, make her strong, so that after marriage she can also take a stand and the society will change. See here, the change is started from a one, okay, not a zero. Change started from one. Means naturally, if you want a change in the society, you have to be the change. In your house, you have to be the change. Take an example. Let's discuss about girls and boys both. Suppose the girl says, no, I will not do this work. This work belongs to him, or his brother, her brother. So tell her. You have to tell your mom that. Tell him that he will do, not I. Similarly, boys also, they should cooperate with their sisters that, please, we can share some of the stuff. Okay, not on regular day, especially on Sunday, you should share the stuff. Okay, means work. That you do kachra, I do pota. But you have to do properly. Otherwise, they have to repeat the task and your mom definitely you will be killed. Because one time you have damaged the task, second time she has to complete it. Okay, so do it properly. But bhale you do one thing. Then, if you do one task at a time, it's well and good, but do it properly. Cooperate with your sister, then and only after marriage you have to cooperate with your wife. Okay? I know that you are thinking, bhai chalne yaar, hoga ye to karenge hum. So, the society will never change. Okay? This was the thought. Yes, Santosh was sixth child. Okay, five nalayaks after six nalayaks. Only layak daughter. Okay, you know that five children, they have five children. Do you know name of anyone? No. But we know Santosh. Five, she was born in the village. Joni was raised in Haryana. Yes, see, she is from Haryana. Okay, Haryana and Punjab are like this. Okay, see, my dole is not, so I am making here dole. Got it? So she was born in Haryana, Joni was Rewari district. Okay, one of the important questions may be asked in exam that Santosh is born in which state, Haryana, which district, Rewari. The girl was given the name Santosh, which means contentment. Santosh means what? Satisfied. Santoshi gaya, meaning that is satisfied. Contentment means. But Santosh was not always content to her place in the traditional way of life. she began living life on her own terms from the start. She started the work on her own terms and condition, that this work is belongs to him, he will do, and this particular work I have to do, I'll complete my task. That's it. No more discussion. This is called your attitude, or we can say your standing point, means from where you are taking stand for yourself. Got it? Good. And one more thing, we don't know that five were like or not like, so we can't say that. Okay, I'm taking entire words in my head again. Okay, as the tear, as that arrow has been passed, been thrown, arrow is thrown. Okay, so forget. The girl was given the name Santosh. Okay, Santosh prefers shorts. Looking back, she says, "No, from the very beginning, I was quite sure that if you chose a correct and rational path, the others around me had a change, not me." Santosh spends for affluent landowners who would afford to send their children to the best schools even in the country's capital, New Delhi. See, their first family is very wealthy. Okay, they have a lots of properties and they were landowners. Means they were already financially powerful. This is the biggest advantage for a girl. See, they are powerful, then they don't have to get under anyone's. Okay, they are not burden to anyone's. Okay, they can do, but still. Power is in hand of a human being only. Human being has a traditional mindset, and if human being is from India, he has an orthodox mindset. So the problem is still there. Okay, that whatever we have will give you, but after your marriage. So what's the purpose of that? How I am going to use my thing, my property, my land, my money? You are not giving me. I'm telling from a girl, I'm pointing from a girl, that the money is not giving to the girls, it's giving to the society, family of that. Are you getting the point? So this is the thing. Okay, now she began living. Okay, I chose correct rational path. That suppose she's walking on a road, the people has to close his eyes or not, instead of staring. Got it? So wait.